An alarming report from the Pentagon reveals that China is actively developing its fleet of long-range bombers and is likely training pilots for missions targeting the U.S. The report also says that China is pursuing a nuclear capability on its long-range bombers. The deployment would be the first time that China had nuclear delivery systems across land, sea, and air.
America in the crosshairs. A new report from the Pentagon says that China is actively developing its fleet of long-range bombers and likely training its pilots for missions over the U.S. Joining me now, CNN military and diplomatic analyst, retired Rear Admiral John Kirby. This is alarming because China's been making military moves for some time to expand its military power and influence abroad. What do we see in this report?
This report, I think, makes clear that they have continued that process, that they view the first two decades of this century as an era of strategic opportunity to expand and develop what they call their comprehensive national power. This report lays out some very specific examples of how they're doing that. So let's take a look at them. They're giving the Chinese Air Force now a nuclear mission, the ability to arm bombers, as you said, Jim, with nuclear missiles that could actually go as far and perhaps be as accurate to attack U.S. targets. That's for the training of their pilots. They're also modernizing the People's Liberation Army to be able to conduct complex joint and out-of-area operations, something we've not seen the Chinese Army able to do.
Until this point, they'd focused their attention on their borders and the immediate surroundings. So now they want to be able to project power where the U.S. is dominant.
Exactly. It's not just about area dominance now, it's power projection in an expeditionary way out of area and across the globe. Also, in keeping with that, they're expanding their ring of bases. So we've talked about the bases in the nine dash line, in the sphere of influence they're creating in the South China Sea, but they're also now trying to contract for and build bases in countries around the world, Pakistan, Djibouti. They really want a more robust global footprint.
Now, the other big adversary, of course, is Russia. And folks, of course, think of Russian cyber attacks, interference in the election, etc. But in space, there's a new satellite that's drawing the attention of the U.S.
This is really flummoxed experts. We're not exactly sure, nobody's exactly sure what this satellite is meant to do. They have been observing very weird behavior from it. It has been sidling up to other Russian satellites. It's been directing itself even to stages, launch stages that put it into orbit. It's been kind of moving over and around them. So it's got some sort of self-movement capability. In addition, it appears to be able to launch smaller satellites out of it. You can see in this video here that it can do that. Now, what we're not clear is if this is just purely peaceful. Is it a repair and refueling capability, or is there a more sinister intent here to maybe weaponize space or to be able to knock out other satellites?
And that, of course, would significantly hurt the U.S. because we're very dependent, both civilian and military, on satellite capabilities. So is the U.S., I mean, one of the big debates has been, does the U.S. then weaponize in space to deter and respond to attacks?
Well, it's a very interesting question. It's controversial. But if you can get the clues for where the United States is going by looking at the National Defense Authorization Act that the president just signed, which authorizes a space warfighting policy and tells the Department of Defense to stand up the Space Command. Not the Space Force, the sixth military branch, but a unified branch.
Right.
Also, look at the National Defense Strategy. If you just look at the first page, these two sentences sit side by side with one another and clearly make China and Russia adversaries of the United States.
And they always, whenever I speak to intelligence officials, they always put China and Russia at the top of their list of threats.
And that's right here.
It is right there. Admiral John Kirby, thanks very much.
You bet.
China is aiming to boost its nuclear weapons capabilities through its long-range bombers. The Chinese military likely training for strikes against U.S. and allied targets, according to the latest Pentagon report. One of the CIA's leading experts on China says China is trying to send a message.
The Chinese do not want conflict, they do not want war, they do not want conflagration. But at the end of the day, they want every country around the world, when it's deciding its interests, its decisions on policy issues, to first and foremost side with China, not the United States.
China's goal?
The Chinese fundamentally seek to replace the United States as the leading power in the world.
President Xi making clear Chinese military power is to be reckoned with. The Chinese have some military advantages. Vice President Mike Pence revealing a U.S. military shortfall.
Hypersonic missiles designed to fly up to 5 miles per second at such low altitudes that they could potentially evade detection by our missile defense radars. In fact, China claimed to have made its first successful test of a hypersonic vehicle.
And a key Chinese advance.
China launched a missile that tracked and destroyed one of its own satellites, a highly provocative demonstration of China's growing capability to militarize space.
But it is here in the South China Sea, in a well-known feud, that the U.S. already finds itself facing off against China. Man-made islands now with airstrips and radar towers, islands capable of housing troops and weapons. It was clear when CNN's Ivan Watson joined a U.S. Navy patrol aircraft that Chinese forces warned the Americans were not welcome. The U.S. crew responded with a carefully crafted message.
United States naval aircraft conducting lawful military activities beyond the national airspace of any coastal state and exercising these rights as guaranteed by international law.
China clearly trying to reshape itself into a global military power. It already has a base in East Africa and working to beef up its relationships with Pakistan. Jake?
All right, Barbara Starr at the Pentagon, thank you so much.
Brian, why are officials keeping an eye on this particular piece of equipment? Is very interesting.
It is, Jim. They're doing that because this satellite seems to have done something that U.S. officials admit they have never seen before. It has birthed two other satellites, according to experts, and they're worried the Russians could use it as a weapon in space. Blasting off from a Russian Cosmodrome, a Soyuz rocket surges into space. Its payload, a military satellite shrouded in mystery. That was in June of last year. Tonight, space and military analysts are investigating whether that satellite is the same one which a top U.S. arms control official said this week was exhibiting, quote, abnormal behavior.
When you look at the entire Russian catalog, this satellite and its children are the ones that jump out as the ones that are acting in an unusual way.
The satellite's children? Experts at the firm Analytical Graphics, who've analyzed this satellite, believe the larger Russian satellite, quote, birthed a smaller satellite a couple of months later. Then, a couple of months after that, the smaller Russian satellite birthed an even smaller satellite.
Almost like a Russian nesting doll.
The Russian Ministry of Defense even announced the first birthing, saying the smaller satellite would, quote, inspect the condition of the larger one. But experts are worried the Russians could be testing it out for military purposes.
The fact that it's the MOD announcing it, the Ministry of Defense announcing that, and it's a secret mission, clearly that's, even if it's a test satellite, it's got some kind of military purpose in what it's testing.
What kind of military purpose? The Pentagon and U.S. Air Force Space Command won't say specifically what they believe the Russian satellites could do. But tonight, a U.S. military official tells CNN the Russians and other adversaries have turned space into a, quote, warfighting domain.
You could see the evolution of that technology in that a single satellite could then sort of give birth to multiple smaller satellites, which would principally be potentially kinetic weapons. Of course, we're thinking later on to the future.
This possible threat is one reason why the Trump administration has been pushing so hard for a so-called Space Force. U.S. military officials have told CNN the Russians have already developed a satellite called Cosmos 2499. They've nicknamed it Kamikaze because they say it could at some point have the capability to go on the attack and slam into American satellites. Experts say the Russians could use satellites to jam American satellites, intercept, or disrupt crucial communications.
A lot of our image surveillance reconnaissance means are space-based, so it's really more United States' ability to see and support of its forces that potentially is threatened.
The Russians are flatly denying the U.S. assertion that they're trying to weaponize satellites.
Ничего нового мы не услышали.
The same unfounded, slanderous accusations based on suspicions, on suppositions, and so on and so forth.
In denying that they have weaponized satellites, the Russians are again pressuring the Americans to join a treaty that would ban weapons in space. The U.S. government has resisted joining that treaty, saying there's no way to verify that Russia and China are curtailing their weapons. And U.S. officials say the treaty has too many loopholes to allow those countries to actually build their weapons capability, Jim. Looks like we have a genuine arms race in space going on right now.
Very worrying development. Brian Todd, thank you very much.